Was the 17th century French thinker Blaise Pascal right? In his Pensées, his thoughts, he writes, "All misery arises from the fact that man cannot stay and sit calmly in his room. We, mankind, can apparently not do differently." The German poet Schiller wrote, "Do know that the deeds and thoughts of man are not like the blindly rolling waves of the sea. His inner self, his microcosmos, is the deepest cave out of which they eternally well up. They are predestined like the fruit of a tree. Coincidence has no hold on them, in spite of his art of conjuring. As soon as I have investigated one's deepest being, I know what he will want and how he will act." But not everyone will put up with that apparent inevitability. Some go into the obscure cave of Schiller to investigate their deepest being. To travel towards the source, towards themselves. So as to arrive home when the circle is closed, their own source. On that journey, they have met with an assistant, on the way to the center of everyone's own cosmos. That without a guide cannot be found. He will be the light into the deep cave. And if you would like so, a guide will come to meet you. Dante already wrote, "It is of all times that people want to undertake that journey. Some who dare to. Will they arrive at the source? Is this the journey, the real one? Where from and where to? And will there be another journey, or won't it be necessary anymore? You travel. You live, alive in what seemed dead before." We follow some travelers on the road to the Buddhist monastery of Swan Mok to find themselves. During 10 days, these travelers will follow a course in Buddhist meditation. 10 days away from the madding crowd, away from home, away from all their cares. 10 days of silence in Swan Mok. The Garden of Liberation. The end of the journey. Paradise.
For many years, he was considered Thailand's leading Buddhist thinker, and in many ways, the most innovative and creative Buddhist teacher in Thai history. And some people would even say the history of Theravada Buddhism. Others would disagree because they don't agree with some of the things he did. So he was also somewhat controversial. He emphasized that to be a good Buddhist isn't so matter whether you become a monk or a nun or not, but it's whether you live out the teachings. And lay people can do it too. So he brought the gap between the ordained Buddhists and the lay Buddhists much closer together. There's still differences. It's a lifestyle choice. Traditional Buddhists are very much interested in what happens after you die. But Ajahn Buddhadasa, when he went back to the Buddha's teaching and read them for himself, he realized that that's not what the Buddha was emphasizing. You find some of that in the scriptures, but it's not the heart. But the heart of it is right here and now, and the birth of the me, the birth of ego, and from that ego birth, selfishness. So he shifted for many Thai Buddhists, and increasingly for Buddhists around the world, the emphasis from after you die, or your supposed past lives, to now, and the rebirth of self here and now. Ajahn Po came to Suan Mok over 30 years ago, and at first was helping Ajahn Buddhadasa, mainly doing some construction work. But he's always been very interested in meditation. So much later, in the 1980s, when he saw all kinds of tourists coming, he started thinking, maybe they should get a little more from their time in Thailand than beaches, beer, hallucinogenic mushrooms and things like that. So he thought maybe to offer them meditation. So he's also the one who started the retreats.
when I wanted to do my trip to Asia, it was not just supposed to be for me a fun trip, not just 5 months of being on beaches. I wanted to do something more. And a Thai monk told me when I told him I was going on my trip and I wanted to do a 10-day retreat because I never did something like that before. He said, go to Swan Mok because there's lots of international expertise for you who are not Thai speaking. You can get a very good education there. You learn how to meditate in a very controlled way, in a step by step.
I remember coming back here from Thailand, and I actually came and just sat here, and it just seemed so peaceful and like walking back into a dream somewhere. And I realized that one of the reasons I'd left Ireland was to try and get a new perspective on my life. Mm-hmm. I mean, I live in a very beautiful place and things seemed to be going well, but I felt like, was this enough for me? So one of the reasons I went to Swan Mok was to look at that. I'd also had a problem with fear before, and I wanted to look at that, and I got a great deal of help in the monastery.
There's so much agitation and chaos in the world that we live in that there is a sense of there's got to be some peacefulness somewhere. And I've got to be able to be introspective and look at myself in a little bit more depth and understand a little bit more. And so that sense of trying to find a retreat, some calmness, some sense of equilibrium, contentment, seems to me to be something that meditators would have in common, and that most everyone is looking for some kind of insight into themselves, some kind of sense of a more tranquil and calm life.
The nicest thing, though, were the talkings I got from a monk, American priest.